Hey guys, how's it going? This is Barry. This is me throwing a wrap left-handed. I'm not a left-handed fighter, and this is my method for how I was able to develop that shot. You see, I've got some guidelines taped down at the bottom, and here's how the method works. So this drill is done in four phases. I start off with 5 sets of 10 flat snaps, followed by 5 sets of 10 wraps. And then the most important phases are 5 sets from the highest position with good form, and then 5 sets from the point of first struggle. Those will be explained at the end, but it really is the most important part of this drill. So please watch the end of the video. Okay, so the very first thing I do here is I just rock back and forth. What I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to train the arm to stay close to the cheek. Okay, so I don't swing wide. That's a big problem a lot of newbies have, is that they swing wide and they try to use their arm. And I'm really getting the hips to rotate on this. I'm just trying to drill this into me before I move on. So the whole point of these 10 steps is that I'm progressively getting more and more difficult. And here we have the flat snaps. Look at how nice and easy that is. That is not meant to be a telling blow. Okay, I'm just trying to learn how to drive with the hips. I'm using almost no arm at all in this shot. Point of this is not to learn how to throw a flat snap. I'm trying to engage the hips before we get to the wrap, because you need to learn how to throw with your hips more so with your arm. Again, a big problem with the wrap is that, you know, people want to use their arm to steer the wrap. Everything's loose. I'm not gripping the sword hard at all. And then notice I'm moving to these different positions. I'm just rotating clockwise to the different positions. And each time I do this, the hip drive becomes more and more difficult. So I start focusing more and more on the hips. And hopefully by this point, the arm has been trained in to stay tight and to stay loose. And then this is the last position that I do with the flat snaps. Now you only see about 2 to 3 swings each here, but I'm really doing 10. And look, even though I'm not moving much at all, look at how the hip is still popping to throw that shot. And again, you can feel this. When you pop the hip, you should feel that 2-pound sword just fly right off of the shoulders without using any arm at all. You use arm in your actual shot, that comes later. Right now, I'm just focusing on driving the hips. Now, before you do anything else, go to the bottom. Look at Count Steinr's video. This is not a technique video. He shows how to throw a technique. That's not the intention of my video. Hopefully you stopped and watched Count Steinr's video. So now I rotate a position back from the start, and I'm throwing at that little target I put in front of there. You see that, that microphone stand? And then I'm letting the sword carry over. Count Steinr explained that very well in his video. So again, I'm learning from the easiest position. I can rotate 180 degrees with my upper body and drive everything with the hips. Move one position closer. Okay, the hips have a little bit less distance to travel. So I have to focus a little bit more to popping with those muscles. I'm just letting physics take that sword over. One more position. Same thing, and you notice I'm actually looking at the microphone stand. I'm not looking at the pel. In your actual fight, you're gonna look somewhere else. But here I'm just really trying to focus on getting that flat snap to carry all the way to the microphone stand. Again, I'm pretty happy with my technique for how new I am to this and for being my left hand. But again, Steinr and Ataias and Sean, linked below, have much better technique, and they do a much better job of explaining technique than I do here. The whole point here is this method. Okay, and then the last piece. So we go through the entire drill of, you've done 10 different steps here. You should have been able to identify at what step did you feel was the last step in which you had good form, and at what step did you feel you started to struggle? Your arm started to go wide. You started to forget to keep the cup hilt next to your cheek. You started to feel like you were steering the shot with the arm instead of letting physics take over. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna do 5 sets of 10 shots from the position of good form. and then 5 sets of 10 shots from the position of first struggle. And this is your practice point. This is the point where you really start to drill in the problems you're having with the rap. This could be step 5 and step 6. This could be step 1. Okay, this is the whole key to this exercise. Anyway, I hope this worked out well for you, and see you on the flip side.